Hi, I'm Josh Ellsworth, General Manager with Stahl's CAD-CUT Direct, and this is a lesson all about blades for cutting heat-applied film and signed vinyl. The first thing you want to understand is the different blades available in the marketplace. There are 45-degree blades, 60-degree blades, 37-degree, 54-degree, 57. There's a range, but typically every cutter manufacturer has at least one low-degree blade. That's typically a 45 that's used for most of your standard vinyl cutting, and one high degree blade, so something close to a 60 degree that's for thicker materials or for more detailed cutting. That's the concept with that. Regardless of what blade you choose, it's important to make sure you have it dialed in correctly. When I go into different shops, that's one of the biggest mistakes. One of the first things I see is that they have the blade sticking out too far. So let's show you an example of that. I've preset this blade how I see it in most shops when I go there. It's sticking out way too far. You really want the extension of this blade to only be going out about a half of a credit card's thickness. So I'm going to retract and adjust this back. And then hold a credit card. Actually, I'll hold a driver's license up to it, just in case you thought you were going to get my credit card number. And you can see up against the license that the blade is sticking out about the thickness of the license. So there's no exact science to this. Actually, there is if you had the right tools, but it's really easy to set it this way. You want it to be half of a credit card's thickness to a credit card's thickness. So this is about right. You want it so it's just barely pricking your finger. So I'll let you get a nice clean view of that. Now that's dialed in properly. That's a Roland blade holder. There's a lot of other blade holders that I have here today. I have a Copan blade holder from US Cutter. I have a GCC blade holder. I also have a Creation blade holder. So there's many different styles, but the concept remains the same for each. You may adjust them slightly differently, but when it comes down to it, you want that blade sticking out only half of a credit card's thickness. The real key is you basically want to cut down through the material, but not through it. So the actual extension will vary based on thickness of the material. If you get close, you can dial in with the downforce on your machine. That's the important thing. So you're not constantly having to change your blade depth. Often people will stock two blade holders, one set up for a 45 degree blade for cutting regular films, and another set up with a 60 or a higher angle blade for cutting thicker materials like flock and glitter or high detailed work on foils, things like that, so you get a cleaner, better cut. It's also important to remember that when you change that angle of your blade, when you change the degree of blade, you always have to change the offset on your cutter. Whoever supplied you with the blade or supplied you with your cutter should recommend an offset for the particular blade that you're using. So a 45 degree blade on the Roland machine is a 0.25 offset. If you switch to a 60 degree blade, the offset switches. So consult with the blade manufacturer or the cutter manufacturer for those settings. Remember, there's varying materials in the marketplace. There's extremely thin materials, there's thicker materials, there's glitters, there's flocks, there's all types of finishes. So you really want to have a basic understanding on how to dial in the blade properly and the downforce properly and the available options to you. Thanks for watching. This has been a lesson on blades.